Politics devolved into fisticuffs after two Republicans in Michigan engaged in a scuffle that sent one of them to the emergency room over the weekend. Now, the fight involved Wayne County Republican James Chapman and Clare County Republican Chair Mark DeYoung. Okay, so there you see their images. Chapman is on the left-hand side, DeYoung is on the right-hand side. Now, let's get to the context of what led to this brawl. So the GOP's state committee came together for a meeting at the Doherty Hotel in Clare as members have been feuding over the party's direction and the leadership approach of the new chairwoman, Christina Caramo, and that's according to the Detroit News. Now, some Republican politicians arriving at the venue on Saturday were pretty frustrated to find that they couldn't enter. It was a closed door meeting that was limited only to members of the state committee. Now, in an interview with the Detroit News, James Chapman, a Republican from Wayne County, said that he had traveled to Clare in order to attend the meeting, but was forced to listen to it through a locked door. He was not very happy about that. So Chapman said, he and others said the Pledge of Allegiance together in the lobby outside the meeting and acknowledged that he wiggled the knob of the door leading into the meeting room. Eventually, Mark DeYoung, chairman of the Clare County Republican Party, heard the wiggling and walked over to the door where he saw someone flip him off through a small window. And he didn't like that. So when DeYoung finally opened the door, all hell broke loose and things got a little crazy, okay? So DeYoung told the press that, quote, he kicked me in my balls as soon as I opened the door.
I mean, that's taking ball busting to a literal degree there, right there, okay?
So the scuffle, believe it or not, intensified with Chapman running at DeYoung and slamming him into a chair during a phone interview from the emergency room, by the way. He noted that he suffered a broken rib as a result of this fight. Chapman alleged that DeYoung had said, quote, I'll kick your ass, and swung at him. DeYoung denied those claims. At one point, Chapman removed his own glasses when things started to get real serious. And he said this, when you see me taking my glasses off, I'm ready to rock. Okay. So then Chapman allegedly proceeded to take DeYoung by the legs and knock him over. Multiple officers were called and they showed up to the hotel after the incident. And DeYoung says he intends to press charges against Chapman as a result of this. So here's an image that was tweeted out. Scuffle breaks out at Michigan GOP state committee meeting. And Mark DeYoung says this, we're so divided, I just wish we could come together. And it warms my heart a little bit because I was under the assumption that it was just the left that engaged in this kind of infighting. But luckily, no, both sides engage in that kind of fighting. Well, I haven't seen any physical stuff on the left, but there's certainly some physical stuff going on the right.
Yeah, I think the two parties are actually super different in this regard. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean the two sides, I mean the two parties, okay? So Anna's right, within like online left wing community, online right wing community, everybody's attacking each other 24/7, right? So we're similar in that sense these days. The left didn't used to attack each other this much, but now it's all bets are off, right? So I get that. But among the political parties, no, so very stark difference. And at this time, it's a rare time where they should meet in the middle. So for the Republicans, they're literally assaulting each other, right? Like, and so
and bragging about it.
Oh, totally. And like,
I'm ready to rock.
Okay, like Marjorie Taylor Greene gets up in Lauren Boebert's face in Congress and calls her a little bitch, and then people start wearing like rifle things, and like there's nonstop. And then the attack against Kevin McCarthy, and I mean it's just a bloody mess, right? There's that Trump supporter who wanted to go potentially kill Obama and Jamie Raskin, but he also wanted to kill Kevin McCarthy, right? They wanted to hang Mike Pence. You remember on January 6th? Yeah. So and meanwhile, this guy comes in and sent the guy to a hospital without how hard he kicked him in the balls. Okay, like this is crazy. No, you got Republicans. You got to dial down that violence. That's insane, right? Meanwhile, the Democrats, exact opposite. Oh my God, criticizing Biden on something he definitely should be criticized about, that he didn't do at all, that he totally lied about. Oh no, 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 I can't criticize him. But the media, what are you yell at me. No, no, everybody's great. Every Democrat's great. The Democratic leaders are wonderful. The Democratic Party's great. I love it when we lose all these elections. They're so great. No, I need you to fight a little bit. Progressives, get in the action. Fight back a little bit, rhetorically, politically, not like the lunatic right wingers with fights and literal fights.
By the way, this apparently isn't the first time that like political tensions among the Republican Party erupted into, you know, fisticuffs, violence. So at least four county parties in Michigan have been at open war with themselves, with members suing one another or putting forward competing slates that claim to be in charge. The night before an April state party meeting, two GOP officials got into a physical altercation in a hotel bar over an attempt to expel members. And so here's footage from that incident between Kalamazoo Republican Party Chair Kelly Sackett and Macomb County GOP Secretary Melissa Pelles. Let's watch.
I answered your question.
Damn, what am I supposed to do with that? Right. You know, it's just interesting because they hear these things and they don't think it's real.
How many lives is that? 22? How many lives is that? 22? By the power invested in me? Is that what you said? You're all going to jail. You're all going to go down. All of you are going down. You're so
fucking out of here.
By the power invested in me, you're no longer not
a Get your cigarette out of here.
Yeah, it's not good. That's don't do that.
So look, the civil rights movement had this great phrase that I love so much. They would create good trouble. That's where they're not the aggressors, but the vicious racist sheriffs in the South would attack them, and then they would get the press to pay attention to that, so they could win over the white population, which they had to in order to get the civil rights back and the Voting Rights Act passed, right? And they would create good trouble after good trouble because they were on the right side of the issues. The Republicans have nothing but bad trouble, like weirdo violence and all that stuff. And on the Democratic side, we have no trouble, nothing, zero, no fight, no spirit, nothing, okay? So this is, the whole thing's out of whack. The one fun part of the story is the glasses. Okay, and there I'm with the brother, even though he's the one that's totally wrong. When I used to fight when I was younger.
You would take your glasses off?
The minute I took my glasses or my jacket off.
You were ready to rock?
Exactly. And my friends would be like, oh boy. If I start taking the glasses off, they'd like, oh Cenk, don't do it, don't do it. So because when you get into a fight, you don't want to get punched in the face with your glasses on.
Of course.
So
yeah.
Right. And then when Alex Jones invaded our set at the 2016 RNC, when I got up, I almost started to take my jacket off, and that's when Ben sprung up.
I remember that,
right?
Yeah.
He's like, I've seen this movie before. And so I hear you, but that's because, look, in that case, the Alex Jones case is totally different. But when I was younger, I was a kid. And a little bit older than that, right? But these are grown adults that are politicians. I mean, this is madness.
And I understand that passions are evoked in these political debates and these political fights, especially when there's disagreement with those on your side. But it's not helpful in any way, and in fact makes your party look foolish if things devolve into violence of any form.
Okay.
Like violence doesn't win anyone over,
100%.
Ever. It just doesn't, it doesn't. Like it doesn't take a freaking rocket scientist to figure that out.
Okay, so I'm gonna give you a poll real quick that's serious and then a lighter thing. 28% of Republicans said it might be time for violence. That's a real poll, they did it twice, 28%. That's tens of millions of people who say it might be time for violence. That's a dangerous trend.
We should also pull the far left on that issue.
Okay, well, that's another, but by the way, they probably have, and it's not anywhere near that number. So anyways, the left is. But now the absurdity. I mean, think, you can begin to see how different the two parties are. Because imagine if, like I criticized AOC earlier in the show for not fighting against Biden enough, right? Mm-hmm. Imagine if the AOC walked in and just kicked Biden in the balls. I'd be like, no, that's not what I meant. That's insane. Imagine if Bernie was like, oh, I don't like the way Senator Coons is treating me. Bam, that's insane, insane. And it's become relatively common in the Republican Party. It's No, this country is like, we've got to somehow bring sanity back. But I don't think either side is saying in the exact wrong directions.
Well, you know, I think who might bring sanity back, Cenk, is freshman Republican lawmaker George Santos, who we will be talking about in our bonus episode for our members today. Because, you know, he fancies himself as like the modern day Rosa Parks.
Okay, yeah. And and we also have, speaking of ridiculous fights among grown ass men, Elon Musk and Zuckerberg, round 8 or whatever we're
Yay.
On. Okay, and now they're literally measuring their penises. Literally, that's the threat. TYT.com/join, become a member. We'll see you there in a minute.
Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.